Well, do you ever get the feeling that the story's too damn real and in the present tense?
Hi, everybody. I'm going to try to do this very fast because I know attention spans are small these days. Mohawk Nation News just put out Get Smart. I'm going to leave all these links below, by the way. The Quebec police in St. John, well, you know what's happening in Ontario right now. Okay, this guy got out, supposedly hit two men in a parking lot who happened to be soldiers. One apparently died. With the cops in hot pursuit, his car flipped over near the Canadian Forces base. Witnesses saw him crawl out with his hands up. They said they heard on the police radio, "Make sure he's dead." The cops shot him 7 times. The guy climbed out of his car, this radical person that's had everything locked down, crawled out of his car and got shot 7 times. I will leave that article for you. Why would this be going on? This seemed like just a guy. It does go on to say that this guy had changed his beliefs. He had converted to Muslim. He went by the name of Ahmed and praised Allah on his website. His passport was confiscated. His murder is like the hanging of 38 Indigenous on December 16th. Canadian media promotes the bombing of the people of Iraq. U.S. President George Bush sat in the classroom while the World Trade Center was being blasted by a nuclear explosion ordered by him. Harper wants to declare war on terror in Canada to turn the billion-dollar 30-day mission into a $10 billion 10-year mission. Okay, that was just something I wanted to read the Mohawk Nation News just put out. However, I think the guy might have been, I don't know if he was a prop or maybe just disgruntled and picked on because he changed his beliefs, or if it was something else. And let me tell you what this something else may be, in my humble opinion. First off, that would be the first link I'm going to leave. Second link, I've told you guys about the CIA, the Cowboy Indian Alliance. They won their lawsuit in Nebraska. The tar sands oil cannot go through. Standing with them, Neil Young, Willie Nelson. I'll leave that link below. Like I said, I'm going to go through this fast as possible. Here's another reason there might need to be a distraction. Chiefs of Ontario say no to fracking. This land is First Nations land. No treaties have ever been honored there. And the Canadian, Harper doesn't know what to do. The Indians are really actually taking back the land, and I'm going to tell you how. But they're saying no to fracking. They're not going to step foot on the land and frack anymore. The tar sands, if you've seen what it's done from above the earth, you can see how scarred the earth is. Now, I'm going to go to, let me go to another website that had something I thought was important on here. And it would have been, oh, yes, what happened recently in Canada? Let me see, where was that? Which, okay, they burnt down, and first of all, some ships were turned around by some Indians, some hauling coal. I'm seeing if I can find that real quick. This just recently, photos, Pacific Climate Warriors block coal ships with canoes. I will be leaving that article for you. This is awesome. This happened October 17th. Also, around the same area, they burnt down a mining camp for big oil or something. I mean, the Indians are standing up. And it was, I think they were wanting something else at this mine. It might have been gold or something. And I can't pronounce your name right, but I know that you're in British Columbia. Secwepemc, some of the Salish tribes, I cannot pronounce your names right. It was Imperial Metals, but they burned down the bridge so that they couldn't come on their land. So the First Nations people have stood up. They put their war paint on. At the beginning of this year, I left a video saying that the nations throughout North America, and that includes Mexico, the indigenous people, have put their war paint on. It's not a game anymore. But the biggest and loudest thing that could hurt Canada and the United States this week, and me and Kitty both were watching this, is they're doing the boarding school tribunal. And that's going to embarrass the Catholic Church, the United States government, and the Canadian government, who have covered up FOIA requests. They have done everything they can to stop this from coming out. And it is going to be live. I've left live stream parts of it up on my Google page, but I will put the link here. I think it goes on for 3 or 4 days. And at the United Nations, nations from around the world, indigenous nations, stood up and said, we're one nation of human beings, and we're not going to let corporations get by with this anymore. So everybody is joining in the fight. And I'm not just talking about Indians, because the CIA, who won their court case in Nebraska, was called the Cowboy Indian Alliance. That means everybody's starting to unite, and that's scaring those people. So they need to put fear into you, so you think a boogeyman's running around while other people are getting business done. And I'm going to tell you, the indigenous people have nothing left to lose. And thank you for those who support and join in the effort, because you are heroes in my book. I wanted to put this out. I'm going to leave all the links. So remember, this could be the biggest distraction, because a lot of things are happening. The chiefs of Ontario said no more. There's not no more of this going to happen. So in Nebraska, no more pipelines going through. That black snake's cut off at the head. What's going to happen? Corporations are going to fail. They're falling. They're losing money. And that was the goal. It's not their land. It's our land. It's my land. It's your land. It's our earth. We're human beings. It's time we started taking care of Mother Earth. All of us. Every single one of us. And fuck these empire systems and these wars. No war. Not in my name. I don't have an enemy except for empires and those who contribute to it. Peace. And I hope everyone has a nice day.